If you have a 3D printer at home, you'll also have a ton of these almost empty filament spools around. They still have too much material on them to throw them away, but also not enough for most projects. In this video, we'll take a look at how you can still effectively use the filament leftovers with features your 3D printer might already have, and also try out a brand new filament splicer, which might be the first affordable and well-working solution to quickly connect filament samples and leftovers to form a new spool and for some nice visual effects. Let's find out more. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is sponsored by us at cnckitchen.store. Stock up on heatset inserts, high quality torque screws and tools all around 3D printing. We currently run a summer sale, so get 10% off your order by using code CNCSUMMER at cnckitchen.store. Free worldwide shipping for orders above 100 euros and general free shipping if you live in Germany. I have a ton of filament samples and 90% empty spools in my office that take up storage space, but I can't get around throwing them away and wasting good material. For years, I've therefore been looking for a splicing tool to fuse these leftovers together and create a new spool from it, which might often still be good enough for printing prototypes. Unfortunately, I've seen and tried several different options. Still, too many either just don't work or were a pain to use, especially if you want to connect to larger pieces of filament. Yet, there's a new kit on the block, but before we take a look at splicing filament leftovers together, let's talk about other options you can already apply on your printer to use up your almost empty filament spools. I'm curious, what are you usually doing with leftover material on spools and filament samples? Let me know in the comments. I might be a bit biased here because when I started 3D printing, filament runout sensors weren't that common yet. Still, as the name already suggests, they are used to inform the user when a roll of filament you loaded isn't enough and therefore pauses the print, and giving you the option to load in new material. And instead of using this as a safety feature, this is a totally legitimate option to get rid of your almost empty filament spools. So just intentionally use the leftover filament and start your print. Once the machine runs out of material, it should pause the printing process and you can load new material. This can be filament of the same color, but if aesthetics don't matter to you, just load in anything else you still have. If everything works as intended, it should leave you with an almost perfect part. This might be tedious because it's a manual process and requires a bit of attention. Yet, you can automate this if you own a BambuLab printer with an AMS unit. The AMS or automatic material system is usually used to make multicolor prints automatically by loading and unloading filaments to the nozzle during printing. Yet the AMS has a rather unknown feature that is perfect for finally using up the leftovers on your filament spools. This is a bit hidden and you need to go into the AMS options to activate filament backup. As soon as you do that, you will see the auto refill option. If you now set the same filament type and color in different slots of your AMS, your printer will switch automatically from one spool to another once one gets empty. This is actually intended for creating big parts that require more than one spool of material, but it is also perfect for our application if we trick it. So you can first start printing with a leftover and then transition to the next spool of similar color, or just load all the bays with different colors if your part doesn't need to be pretty. This, by the way, works on the normal AMS, but also on the AMS Lite. On the P1P, P1S and the A1 series printer, you need to activate this in Bamboo Studio under the device settings. If you own a PrusaXL, you can actually do something very similar. When you start a print on the XL, you can map the filament that the G-code is asking for to a spool that's loaded on the printer. Yet, you can assign more than just one spool. Selecting spool join tells the printer which tool heads have the same material loaded and can therefore also be used to switch spools once filament runs out. So just like on the Bamboo, as soon as the filament runout detector notices that it has reached the end of the spool, it will park the current tool head and pick up the next one that you joined together. And this can of course be used to make a print that requires more than one spool of the same material, or you can also load all your leftovers and just use up one after another. Yet, what do you do if you don't have a PrusaXL or a BambuLab machine with an AMS, and you also don't want to camp in front of your printer all night to switch materials when it's time to? Well, in a case like this, you can splice the ends of two filament spools together so that they automatically feed one after another. The easiest way is just to heat up the ends and, once molten, push them together so that they fuse. This, of course, leaves you with a huge weld that wouldn't feed in your printer. So you take a flush cutter or a knife and cut off the excess and clean everything with a piece of sandpaper. You might have already been able to tell that this is a pain, and I would only do that in the most dire situation. There are some commercial tools on the market that try to assist you in that process, but none of the ones I know and I tried were really satisfying. A couple of weeks ago, SUNLU sent over one of their upcoming products, which is a filament splicing tool that finally tries to make it right. This video isn't sponsored by them, which you might already be able to tell if you see that the presale ended, you can't order it anymore, and the first batch won't be available before the end of the year. So, if you want to support my work over here without using affiliate links, check out our shop at cnckitchen.store, where we are currently running our summer sale. Purchase the first lead-free brass-threaded inserts, special tips for your soldering iron to install them, great quality Torx screws, and other accessories all around 3D printing. You can now get 10% off your order by using code cncsummer at cnckitchen.store. We have free worldwide shipping for orders above 100 euros and general free shipping if you live in Germany. Ordering directly from our online store is the best way to support us. But now back to the filament splicer. The set consists out of the filament connector and a bag of thin-walled PTFE tubes, to which we come later. The unit is pretty compact, powered by USB that requires a power supply capable of delivering at least 2 amps of current. This powers the small touchscreen in the front and, of course, the heater on the inside. With a 10 watts of available power, it takes a while to warm up. Some filament profiles are stored on the device, but you can also manually change the temperatures. The splicing process is straightforward. You take the ends of your filament and cut them at an angle to increase the surface area where they will fuse. Then you slide the PTFE tube over the end and insert the second filament into the other side so that they can touch. Now you simply open the inner lid of the splicing machine, which reveals the heating element, insert your filaments that are held together by the PTFE tube, and close the lid while making sure that the ends touch. Once the unit beeps, you can open the locking mechanism and remove your spliced filament. At this point, it's still a bit soft in the middle, so you'll have to let it cool down a little. Then comes the ingenious step, especially if you want to splice longer pieces of filament. Other solutions I previously found online often require to drag the complete filament left over through the splicer, yet SUNLU's connector does it differently. To remove the small PTFE tube, you clip the welded filament into a slot in the back of the device, which contains a cutter. By pressing down the transparent lid, you push the encased filament onto the blade, which slices the tube and makes it very easy to remove, leaving you with a nice and strong connector between the two strands. So much for the theory. I did quite a bit of slices myself. SUNLU's filament connector still requires a bit of practice to get really nice connections. First of all, you need to make sure that your filament doesn't bend too much at the location where you want to splice, because this can make placing the pieces into the slicer more tricky, and the stress can cause your splice to deform when you remove it and it's still hot and soft. So I always try to straighten my filament ends a little and place the spools at a location where the ends were not under stress. I also made sure that both sides of the filament follow the same curve, so I don't have to twist or bend them when re-spooling. Then you also need to slightly push the ends together during the process in order to make sure that they properly bond. Yet if you push too much, your splice section will get too thick, which can potentially cause a clog in the filament path during printing. I tend to slightly squeeze the spliced section with my fingers when it's still soft, and I also very gently pull the ends apart to get a splice with a diameter that is rather too low than one that is too thick. Depending on the material you splice, you also want to play around with the temperatures a little. I had the feeling that I would get more reliable connections if I slightly lowered my PLA temperatures. The unit can heat up all the way to 240 degrees Celsius, so there is room to play, and you will be able to splice most common filaments, including ABS, ASA, polycarbonate, and nylon. There is also a small design flaw in the machine, and this is that the upper part of the filament splicer can get really hot when you use it for a bit. It's not as hot that you instantly burn your fingers, but it gets so hot that pushing down the lid can be unpleasant. Maybe they can improve this in the next version. Another thing I was really wishing for was some kind of an integrated cooling fan where I could quickly cool down my splice after I take it out of the heater. I currently blow on it myself, but moving the splice section can already ruin it. Interestingly, during my research, I stumbled over a tool called the hexagon or 3D sway filament connector, which has a very similar workflow to SUNLU's unit, yet seems to integrate a cooling system. I don't know which one came first and if one was inspired by the other, but there is a clear resemblance. If somebody of you has some insight here, please let me know. But yeah, that's it for SUNLU's filament connector. I was honestly pleasantly surprised when I first tried out the splicing tool because I had been looking for something like this for ages and even considered building one myself. Yes, there are even automated ones, with Pellet's mosaic system being the most prominent, but they all are either more complex and expensive or just don't work as well as this solution right here. In my opinion, SUNLU succeeded in adapting the best of the available systems and compacting it and improving them to make their unit simple and affordable. The reason why the system works so good might also be the most repelling one, and this is the use of these small PTFE tubes. The standard set contains 200 of them and they are a consumable, so you could argue, isn't it like self-contradicting when you reduce the amount of filament that's thrown away by now disposing of small PTFE tubes? In my opinion, they are the necessary evil here that enables the system to work so much better than anything else I've used before. They help align the filament, avoid any flashing whatsoever, and eliminate the necessity of reworking your splice. And this is at the expense of waste and a couple of cents in cost. Yet, if we weigh one of these tubes, we quickly see that their mass is just as much as two purge lines of your 3D printer, so the amount of waste is tiny. And you don't have to necessarily slice them after splicing. If your filament pieces are not too long, you can also just simply slide them off and reuse them. These are all reasons why I give SUNLU's filament connector a big thumbs up. I think this is currently the best bang for your buck filament connector on the market, if you have a use for it. It's not flawless and might need some practice, and even though I won't use it every day, it will be a quick and handy tool for many shops. Well, once it's available for purchase. Yet, you don't necessarily need a filament splicer. As I've tried to show you in the beginning, using filament leftovers might be easier than you thought with the tools and features you already have. Still, I am really curious because I've been looking for a filament connector like this one for a while. Do you also see use for one of these filament connectors in your shop and workflow, or do you have different uses for your filament leftovers? Please leave your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you found this video interesting. If you want to support my work, head over to Patreon or become a YouTube member. Also, check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye.